there's a lot of more marksmen available in the meta.
Yep, yep. And again, guys, this is game number two of our second series, Team Vietnam ahead against Team Malaysia with 1-0 score for a best of 2 series. Again, guys, we can see right now Team Malaysia on their comfort fit. Pick action with that Luo Yi and Hyde is being taken here with the first blood for Rumpel. So, Wolf, this is the opportunity actually to see Rumpel on that Kufra again. Earlier, Team Vietnam banned out this Kufra against Team Malaysia. So, it's more the comfort pick for Team Malaysia onto this game. But little wonder it has been secured here by Team Malaysia. And we might see an contest for the buff, but I guess it's gonna be a disengage. But again, here comes the vacuum for Ominous on that Louie. Massive damage, actually. This is destructive damage, to be exact.
I kind of figured out what the strength of the Louie is. If you imagine that vacuum that we're talking about, that big circle in the middle, it covers a big area, almost the entirety of the mid lane when it comes to the laning stage. That's why if you look at Team Vietnam, they can't even position themselves into that part. And it also means that other members of Team Malaysia can go for invades, like what they did with the Thams taking the orange buff and the Kufra getting the purple one. So Team Vietnam absolutely has nothing for Broly at this point. Our Granger, it just means that this Granger, the win condition for the Granger is already lost. You need to get your farm, you need to get your buffs secured for some an early game item dependent hero like that of the Granger. And the fact that you're not getting it, it just means that Team Vietnam will have so much of a hard time in this mid game.
Yep, speak of which, we have a level 6, actually, Lancelot, from Team Malaysia onto this game. So we could see already the fruit of the farm against Team Vietnam. Just like what we've been saying earlier, for a Granger, you need all the criticals, you need all the farm to be in par with the damage here coming from Team Malaysia. Although, for Team Malaysia, in terms of late game, though, sword is down, actually, with the hands of Broly on this Granger. And speak of which, it's Broly. It's Broly of Team Malaysia. No doubt about Broly in terms of skill, individual skill for this kind of player of Team Vietnam. Although, for Team Malaysia, I guess they really need to be mindful of the late game, because it's the late game. If you have the immortality for your team, it's kind of difficult for a Lancelot to bring down players. Yep.
Okay, so I think that right now we are seeing a little bit of comfort for the Granger, because it's the second round of buffs. It means that they will be able to secure it. That's a very important kill that they were able to get. They'd never have to undermine the strength of this Rumble and Koopa in combination with the Atlas. You can be chain stunned by that combo. And in fact, they'll get another kill. Dominus, the Louis will be taken out. Bottom lane, there's a little bit of a tussle arts between arts, as well as this Esmeralda from the Tidetry. I hope I didn't butcher the name. Given that the Thamsa is actually leading in terms of EXP and is going to be chased down by the members of Team Vietnam, they jump in. And that is going to be Thams out so easily with just one chasm leap.
Okay, actually, there's a bit of a hope for Team Vietnam onto this game. We have the Atlas to get the Granger together. But although on the middle lane, it's going to be another kill for Sworn into this Lancelot. We have the Falling Storm and for the Esmeralda. Atlas was there, but it is going to be a mislead for the team fight for Team Vietnam. And speaking of which, we have the physical damage, skill-wise per se, normal hit for the Lancelot of Team Malaysia. All they need to do is to refrain from a Broly or avoid Broly being taken down by Team Malaysia onto this game.
You can see now in the middle part of the map, there's a little bit of a clash happening with a very nice dodge there coming out from a sword on this Lancelot, using the Thorn Rose and the dash, the puncture, to just get away so safely against his teammates. And now the question is Broly ready to fight? Is he battle ready at this point? Obviously, the answer is not yet. But I guess with that one kill that he was able to get, at least there's a little bit of recovery coming off this Granger. Lancelot jumps in, wants to go for hide, and he is going to be able to hide, though. Rumpel, fatal licks, the flicker away coming out from Rumpel. The Atlas still looking for a target. Hide is so low, going to be taken down by the Thames. Oh! And there's another kill, the Granger taken out as well. The Ozorovecki wants to go for more. The Scales Ball going to be used. A nice flicker onto the left side. A Spiritify as well coming out from Depth tried to not be taken out by Team Malaysia, but nevertheless, Malaysia is still winning this heavily shot belt.
Actually, for this one, we can see already the damage together with the Ozorovecki on the Lunox for Team Malaysia. So that is one bit of a problem for Vietnam on this match. We have the Lancelot. They have the Lancelot, rather, for Team Malaysia plus this Lunox. So I guess for Vietnam, they need to secure the objectives against Team Malaysia if they want to turn the things around. If you want to breathe for this kind of rotation coming from Team Malaysia, they must do a split push onto this one. Although we can see T-Dip try onto this one. Hyde is almost out of life. And that is going to be another kill for Lunox or Ozorovecki of Team Malaysia. And Dominus with that Winter Truncheon securing for the defense item, actually for the micro skills here onto this game. Enchanted Talisman though for the Esmeralda Team Vietnam. Enchanted Talisman for a 6-minute game. What do you think?
Nevertheless, there's a teleportation. One of the bigger ones they get to so easily. Enchanted Talisman is such a good item, Chantel, to answer a question. But the real question is, can Team Vietnam survive this thing? Use a very nice Fatal Links, but the answer is no, as there's so much early game damage from Team Malaysia that we're seeing right now. And it feels like this is going to be an easy game for Team Malaysia, as the timing for the Grangers has already expired. In comes the Lancelot with the Thorn Rose just zoning out the members of Team Vietnam, as Team Malaysia is aiming to push this inhibitor in the middle. They weren't successful in doing so, but a slight HP left here for the inhibitor turret in the middle.
For Team Malaysia, the damage is just there. They have the Kufra for the AoE. So far for Team Vietnam, I'm not seeing the wow moments for the Atlas Fatal Link. So I guess it's going to be the turnout of events for Team Vietnam if they are able to pull off a certain type of initiation wherein they take at least three or four players here for Team Malaysia. Although for this one, they need this Granger to cope up with the gold for the damage per se, because for Team Malaysia, it's all about this Lance. It's all about the looks. Double L combo for Team Malaysia on this game. And we are seeing right now, it's going to be 210 for the score. It's 10k gold lead for Team Malaysia.
Jumping from Rumble though with the bouncing ball. Even T-Max is hurting from all of the percent base damage coming out from the Lunox. That's Ozorovecki. This farmed Lunox just means that even the tankiest of the tanks will be melted down. You have to take note, this is Impure Rage Lunox, a Stone of Legends from way back when, and it still is proving to be effective if given to Team Malaysia.
Yep, and for Team Malaysia, we could already see the damage being brought here by Dominus, actually the Lu Woyi of this team. Just the one vacuum and the majority of the health fades away for Team Vietnam. Although we can see here right now the aggressiveness of Team Malaysia onto this game. It's 31k versus 21k of Team Vietnam. For Team Vietnam though, they need to be mindful of the Thams or the sustain. Here we have the die. Oh my god, it catches three for this Kufra out this game, and a mega kill for Sorn. There comes the Falling Storm from Deptry, but the top lane turret is destroyed plus the BOT for Team Malaysia. I guess this is gonna be a tower lock, but another damage here coming from Team Malaysia. On this game, we have the Esmeralda low on life.
Oh, look at Sorn.
Here comes the minion wave. Yep. Here comes Sorn with the damage, but Sorn is still alive. Falling Storm here coming from him. The Esmeralda, the free hit, but Chaos Assault. It's gonna be a kill spree for this Kufra, and I guess Malaysia Malaysia just needs to go for the tower lock. They have the cannon for this one. Another minion wave actually for this game number two. And it is really going to be a win for Team Malaysia.